testified probably 20 minutes ago, but there's two additional witnesses that were not disclosed either in the trial witness list or in any subsequent witness list for sentencing that are out here this morning and that the state may introduce as witnesses. I do object. I believe that the testimony hasn't, well, I haven't had an opportunity to expose these people, especially one that may have testimony that is prejudicial and without verification, certainly from our side. So first, I would object to either of these witnesses being admitted at sentencing without notice to us. I would put on the record that we have filed supplemental witness lists, disclosed all our witnesses weeks in advance to the state. So this is news to us. One other thing I'd like to put on is simply, Judge, for you to consider, we don't, it's untested whatever this testimony is going to be, and we don't have representatives from the Veterans Administration here to actually meet out specifics about what may or may not happen. What we know to be objectively true is that Mr. Jackson served in the Marine Corps from 1990 to 2007, was honorably discharged. That's true and uncontested. I don't know what else might be coming in from some random testimony.
Okay.
Ms. Thomas? Judge, I don't plan on calling these two as witnesses for the state. However, I've been notified that Robert Christopher Germain and Ms. Angela Jackson are present, would like to be heard for the court. They'd like to speak on behalf of or towards the character of Mr. Jackson. Ms. Jackson was married to Mr. Jackson for going on 9 years, I believe, totally, including possibly a separation. She would like to speak. And then a gentleman that I met for the first time this morning is here. He was unsolicited by the state. I did not reach out to him. To my knowledge, no witnesses reached out to him to track him down. He's a former Marine that served with Mr. Jackson. He was under his direct supervision for 6 months. He has a problem with things that have been stated regarding Mr. Jackson's service and his relying on the service for litigation. And just as a side note, once again, he would like to speak. I'll explain to him that I'm not calling him as a witness, that the board is inclined to allow people to speak if they'd like to speak, and he intends to do so. However, as a side note, the sentencing memorandum, I believe that his testimony would be relevant or rebuttal with no other reason. Then there was a sentencing memorandum that was filed Friday afternoon after hours that I have received. I'm asking for a continuance. However, what I've read from that memorandum is I do believe that now they have made it an issue, not only the service, but the content and character of Mr. Jackson during the service in the Marine Corps. So I feel if Mr. Germain would like to speak as to his personal experience and knowledge being under the supervision of Mr. Jackson during those years, he's the only person that can actually contest the statements that's been made by Mr. Jackson in writing. So the court is inclined to allow individuals not listed as witnesses to provide additional statements if they would like, and I feel like this would be an appropriate time to do so, Judge.
Okay. Well, I think that if people have relevant testimony to offer, then the court should hear from them. Mr. Pinella, I can do a couple of things. I can give you some time to speak to them before sentencing. I can delay the sentencing if you feel like you need to do more than just speak to them or have argument regarding possible conflicts or motives to not be truthful. But I'm inclined to hear from anybody that has testimony that is arguably relevant to your sentencing memorandum, which I read over the weekend, and you clearly place Mr. Jackson's military history and his character into play. And so I would think it would be relevant.
the time they're on. I hesitate, truly, to say this, as we have been anticipating this day and would like to go forward with sentencing, but Judge, I do think it is appropriate and responsible for us to delay sentencing. So I've got an opportunity to pose these two witnesses. As far as what the other witness, the non-VA witness, what Ms. Thomas just disclosed to me she may testify to, I also think is very important for me to determine the veracity of that. And I currently, because it's news to me, have no way to rebut this anticipated testimony that was just told to me. If it's true, it's true. If it's not, it's not. And I think that I would not be doing my job for Mr. Jackson to not thoroughly investigate these claims. And so, Your Honor, I'm set to be moving to any continuum, but under these circumstances, that is the option that I would request of the court.
All right, Ms. Thomas.
We're gonna object to continuance, Judge. State also has a way to know that Mr. Germain claimed on speaking. However, it's in the purview of the court. He has, the only reason I had a conversation with him prior was obviously when anyone takes the stand on behalf of the state, it can be seen as if it's a body case. I wanted to make clear to the court that this isn't something that we sought out. I actually have an investigator that's trying to do due diligence, and that's why I said I was not going to call him as a witness, but yet I explained to him that it is the decision of the court to speak. You know, we are here where a motion, a 27-page memorandum, was filed Friday after hours, and we pulled together what we could based on the memorandum. I explained that if there were things in it that I needed to go into, that potentially would be a continuance. However, I was trying my best not to do that, and we've been prepared over the weekend to go forward. I think that it's common sense, if you're going to put a motion like that in the record, that you should expect and anticipate potential rebuttal testimony, especially if the latest of that motion would be filed. The right of sentencing is a different standard for evidentiary purposes. Anyone in the public, I would submit, can technically come in and give a statement if the court were to allow them to, so it's in your discretion. We've explained to Mr. Pinella that he can have a moment to discuss the testimony with Mr. Germain. I've explained to him what Mr. Germain has explained to me would be his testimony, and it directly goes to the statements that's included in Mr. Pinella's own motion. As far as Ms. Jackson, it's simple character evidence, and I don't feel that that's also prejudicial to the defense, especially when she's testified at pretrial motions prior about Mr. Jackson's character, or she felt it to be. So we ask the court to allow Mr. Pinella to speak with these witnesses, take a moment to see if he feels like he can move forward. I don't think there's anything that he could gather from them outside of a deposition rather than just setting a record for the purpose of impeachment moving forward.
Let me ask you this. I've never had a situation in 30 years of people wanting to come in and testify to the court that they were not brought by the state.
Yes.
So I haven't done any research on it.
I met him for the first time this morning. I think Mr. Stadler had mentioned his name to me, and I told Mr. Stadler that I didn't think the testimony would be relevant. All I knew at the time was he was a prior member of service with Mr. Jackson. Then the motion got filed on Friday, and now the gentleman is here. Why am I behaving? I don't even have contact with this gentleman. Now my thoughts are different. The fact that the motion heavily discusses the military service for purposes of mitigation, I think that this gentleman's testimony would be relevant. So I haven't had this issue before either, Judge. I don't have any research on it. I spoke with him for the first time about 30 minutes ago and immediately told Mr. Pinella. But I understand if the court does feel that he needs to speak with him, but he's not listed as a witness from the state in order for him to be deposed.
And my issue, I want this to be final.
Yes.
You know, so if we all want to take 15 or 20 minutes and do some research on it, this is the deal, is that if there's relevant information regarding a possibility or a factor that the defense is going to argue regarding a downward departure, if there's relevant information, I want to hear everything. feel like that both sides, and I know you didn't know about this either, but both sides should be aware of what's coming in to be able to vet that information. And so that's my concern, is I don't want to have this 3-hour sentencing and then end up having to redo it because we've done something that we shouldn't do. I feel comfortable with analyzing people's testimony and being able to weigh it and give it the due credibility and weight that it deserves. But if the defense is concerned about what's coming in, then, you know, I want to give everybody the ability to vet this if necessary. So why don't we take 15 minutes and do some research on citizens coming forward to testify to sentencing not being brought by the state and for the defense. If somebody just wants to come in and testify, see what my parameters are, and then I can make the decision. Okay, so maybe you guys start recessing.